four trays of 72 cells each, all corn, rare heirloom corn, could all just die in the freeze. It's that time to plant the corn. The green room is overgrown and I have peppers coming up that need shelf space. This is a learning situation here for planting corn. I'm doing it by hand with a butter knife and a little dig tool, just digging up the ground like that, placing the seed pod in there, taking this, going straight into the cavity of it and pulling it out like that, and the roots come pulling right out, and then you just place it right in the hole, bury it with the soil that you just dug up, and put it in there. I have run out of soil and money, so I can't buy anything. I don't have anything but the soil, and I dug this whole one by shovel. I took a shovel and I dug it up and flipped it over and chopped it up because it's sand. It just falls apart. You just take the top roots and leave them upside down and they'll die and won't grow. It looks good. And that's really good. I can put the bleeder hose right in it. But the next row over here, I did just with, like I just showed you, with the butter knife. And I did it by hand. And I'm just getting on my knees and crawling between the rows, keeping my feet together so I don't crush the plant. And I do the same thing down this row, which is a little bit wonky. I started getting too close and had to space it back out again. It should be 1 foot apart. And each row should be 2.5 to 3 feet apart. My theory is if it's 1 foot apart one way, it can go 1 foot apart the other way. Now I understand with wind pollination, they're telling you to space them either further between the rows. You should be able to walk between the rows for harvesting. When you're doing on a small farm like this and you're just doing a little area like this, it is fine to just do 1 foot apart. You'll be able to walk through this little square patch here of 8 rows and do this. Now starting row 4, and it's actually that one's buried wrong, way too close to this row, so I got to move over, but I was just showing you guys. It is very warm out, but we have a cold spell coming, which is a little worrisome. I may be doing all this work just to watch them die. They have to come out of the seed starter tray or they will die. They'll get root bound and they're getting laggy. I can't allow that. So they have to go in the ground. There's no choice. I don't have the right soil. I don't have everything. So what lesson is this? This is a lesson that's telling me, again, John, slow down. I get so excited with seeds and planting that I just can't stop myself. I'm like, I have seeds. I must plant. I want to plant. I just got to go. And I think sometimes us gardeners really just go overboard by doing too much too soon. And the love of gardening and everything, we just have to pull back, because now we're at a situation where 4 trays of 72 cells each, all corn, rare heirloom corn, could all just die in the freeze. Because I jumped the gun and I tried to get ahead and I didn't want to slow down, and I had shelving space at the time. My other thing is peppers. I'm growing over 50 variety of peppers, hot peppers from ghost peppers and reapers and scorpions and everything, bananas and jalapenos and bells and everything. So all the different chocolate varieties and colors and Chinese five color and jigsaw and all the good stuff, right? So again, peppers, and I know that the peppers take long. I know that they can take up to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 weeks sometimes. And there is a fine trick to seeds and growing peppers. And I know it, but I got impatient. And when we get impatient, we end up hurting things. So let my mistake, yet again, be a lesson for you. A lot of people just show you that they're gardening and everything looks beautiful and it's all great and everything. Guys, I am documenting this for my family. If my daughter or granddaughter ever want to see it, cool. If not, whatever. But this is real life. This is not for commercials and money and all that other stuff. This is to learn. So learn. Slow down. Slow and steady wins the race. Don't be in such a rush to plant. Make sure that you have the soil, the garden space, and everything you need prior to doing it. Schedule it and plan it. Therefore, you never get into the situation that I'm in now, having to work overtime just to plant seeds and plants because I planted too much and they all germinated. Those peppers that I was like, they're not going to germinate. Now, I mean, I was talking to Veronica. She was over here last weekend or so. And I said, nah, I don't think they're going to come up, blah, blah, blah. And both of us were saying, you know, peppers, they take time, you know, blah, blah, blah. And what did I do? I still ignored my advice, her advice, let it sit, just wait. But go ahead, we'll just start another. I got to just start another one. I'm going to do another 2 or 3 trays. Well, they're all coming up now, the ones that I planted first. So I'm going to have double the peppers now. And because the peppers are rarer than the corn has to go on the ground or I'll lose it anyways. Catch 22. Well, live and learn. So here we go. Back to crawling on my knees, slaving on the ground to plant corn, and hopefully it makes it through the frost. The regular garden's up there doing great because it's nice and warm. Lettuce is doing wonderful. You can see half of it from here. It's so beautiful. But got to get to the corn. All right, guys, short, just a little update about the planting and my mistakes. God bless, and we'll see you in the next video. Like, share, subscribe. Bye-bye.